My name's Adam Clark, I'm Deputy City Mayor and I chaired the project board for the Townscape Heritage Initiative. In Leicester, after the discovery of King Richard III, we wanted to capitalise on that amazing moment, and we recognised that the streets around where Richard was found and the buildings could do with some TLC. And we were so grateful to the Heritage Lottery Fund that they supported us with a grant to enable us and the businesses and private houses within this area to benefit from that funding. So the project worked by working alongside people in this community, in the conservation area community, to encourage them to look at the work they needed to do to really bring their buildings up to a standard that demonstrates the value of the area. This is an incredibly important part of the city centre, the old town, the old legal quarter. If you look really carefully at these buildings, you can almost see the stories from them coming out, and we wanted to support people within the area to get those buildings up to that standard where people would value them.
My name is Alice Hubbard. I'm the manager of the Two-Toed Lion. The Two-Toed Lion's on Millstone Lane in Leicester City Centre. This is really nice and unique here. Got this kind of untraditional sort of feel to it, but inside it looks and feels like an old school pub. We've got lots of like ghostly kind of memories of what it was when it was a solicitor's, sort of like where they've had the decals on the windows. When it steams up, it'll show through. And it's just so unique and cosy, and the area is lovely. We call it Beer Street, like the Hogarth painting, because there's so many pubs down here. We've had some amazing stuff done to the area that's kept it looking really nice and kind of clean and gorgeous. New paving, there's some lovely signs. We've had some bike racks put up right near us, which is brilliant for the customers that come and want to cycle in and wobble home. We were lucky to have a grant to reinstate the windows, basically, to kind of how they were before. You can see behind, and had the lovely decal of the Two-Toed Lion logo there. Also a downpipe outside with some nice detailing, and a new front door, which has just really kind of brightened the whole area at the front for us as well. People love it when they see it. They don't notice it, to be honest, because everything fits in so well. But it's just a nice place to grab a drink. It's cosy and it's quiet, and it's perfect for the type of people that pop in and see us here.
So what investment in the area has done, in the built heritage of the area has done, has also enabled us to invite people into the area to do some really exciting things, whether that be using Sundays to close the streets off and bring people in to enjoy the community, take part in family activities, or to encourage businesses to come and look at some of the vacant buildings that were in the area and move into those buildings to make them part of the local economy and contribute to the local economy of Leicester. So the work that we've done has not only had value for the buildings, but the people of Leicester have begun to value this area much more than they did previously, which is wonderful for the City Council, but it's also wonderful for residents of the city. What's quite difficult to really recognise as you stand in the conservation area is the amount of real skill, traditional heritage skill, that's gone into repairing some of the real features of the area. And some of those you really have to look for from street level, but they're of immense value. And we've been able to promote heritage skills during the project as well. We've been able to support the training of people in those heritage skills so that those skills remain. And so when these areas like the Greyfriars Conservation Area need to be looked at again in the future, there will be people there that will be able to do the work that we've done recently. So we really feel like the value is not just in the buildings per se, but also in the skills that we've been able to continue into the future. The project would not have been possible, obviously, without the funding from lottery payers, but also from the broad partnership that came together to deliver the project. Of course, thanks must go to Leicester Civic Society, who were there throughout the project, supporting and advising all those people involved in the project to make sure we were as true to the heritage of the area as we possibly could be. But there was a range of other partners that inputted into the project, from architects, from local historians, to those businesses in the community, to the cathedral and the Diocese of Leicester, who obviously have a real stake in this area with the cathedral just being on the edge of it. So there were a range of partners that worked so brilliantly together, and without that partnership we wouldn't have had the brilliant outcome and the brilliant revitalised area that we've got now.
So I'm Justin Weber and I help project manage the scheme for the City Council. One of the key things we were looking to do through the project was work beyond just the immediate area, and so we were able to do quite a few outputs over the 5 years, including setting up a new Georgian history group for the wider county, which has had a number of events. We also set up a new public lecture series with the three local universities, which has been attended by hundreds of people. We tapped in some of the bigger events, so we had an event as part of the nationally recognised Leicester Comedy Festival with a local youth group called Focus Charity, who did a historical play based on the local area. And also we added activities as part of the very successful Ride Leicester Festival, as well as organising our own local open streets project, working again with the sustainable transport team, bringing people into the area. This is the legal quarter of Leicester, so we've been able to do a number of events and projects, and a lot of that can be seen on the Legacy website, where there's interviews with people that used to work in the area talking about the legal history and some of the more interesting stories. We've got a new interesting map which you can use to explore the area, done by a cartoonist. The area has improved both as a sort of tourist destination, which enhances the wider city centre offer, but we've also seen it enhance other aspects. A local company based in the south of the city, Panthrella, who are recognised across Europe as a high-end manufacturer of things like socks and scarves, they actually came to the Greyfriars area towards the end of the project, and because the area had been improved sufficiently and was providing that nice kind of background aspect, they actually used it for filming one of their adverts for their new product line. So it gives a sense of how the area has improved, such that you've got this internationally recognised company using this area as a basis for their own promotion.
I think everybody would agree that in Leicester that this has been an incredibly successful project, but not only that, we know that beyond Leicester, the funders, the National Lottery Heritage Fund, are so pleased with the work that we've done and how we've gone about our work. And it really has transformed. The Greyfriars Townscape Heritage Initiative has transformed a part of the city centre. And let's not forget, city centres at the moment are under more pressure than ever to sustain themselves. And I'm passionate that if we look at heritage and conservation, then we might see the answers to the future of city centres. And I think what we've done here in this part of the city centre is demonstrate that that is true.